the cantilever beam. That's the basic, we know it's determined. So other than that, we will pretty much improve it. So for that, we say, okay, the way we can do it is to find out, you select one that has redundant restriction, and then you remove that. How do you remove that redundant one? That seems to be part of the redundant system, right? But you cannot just screw it up. So you can remove it, but replace it with the reaction. Either reaction force, or movement, or both. Put it there, and then treat it as a load. Then you can do all the solution problems. So the way you can solve it is, let's say, use a movement equation, or use a load equation. You can solve it, but then, you know, this reaction, you still don't know. So how do you find it? It's an additional boundary condition. Define this value. So that's like the compatibility. So the compatibility is additional boundary condition that make where you have the additional reaction, additional restriction, make it fit the original one. We're going through a couple examples, right? So we use an equation to solve it. So today we go through a different one. That is using superposition. So it's only being whether you can use the equation with integral, or you can use superposition, right? And from all your feedback, say, right, the superposition is easier. Because you just buy the solution from the textbook, from the paper, and then you add them together. That looks like a much easier job than you do all the integral between the boundaries. So today we're going to use superposition to solve the same problem we covered before. Right, so we start with just an example. Okay, so for this one, first, we know it's indeterminate, right? Question about that. But this basically is like a cantilever beam. You have an additional line of support on the right. So this make it can be the redundant restriction. If you remove it, change as RB, right? That's one way. Of course, we said there are multiple ways you can treat, you can call a load redundant. But there are here three reactions. MA, RA, and RB, so the three. Of these three, you can pick any one. Right? But since you can pick any one, but it takes oftentimes pick the easy one. That is, when you remove this one, then you can quickly get the beam to become a simple, either a single beam or a cantilever beam. Because single beams and cantilever beams, we know there's long painful solutions. So that's why you want to somehow reduce either a single beam or a cantilever beam. And that's the best way. So that's like a hint, or a tip for you to solve a homework problem or exam problem. So just try your best to reduce the single beam. Okay. So in this script, now let's look at this beam. So let's say we remove the RB as redundant. Okay. If you remove RB as redundant, then this beam becomes like you have a distributed load here, right? And then you also have RB here. You have like two loads. RB. So therefore, for this beam, it's a cantilever beam. It's like a determinant beam. And for determinant beam, I have two loads, the load and the RB. So we find this solution through the superposition. Yes, we can do that. Okay, so basically we change this beam, divide up into these two ones. Right? We suppose the solution, the top one becomes at the bottom. Alright? Okay, now, let's say you can find the solution for the top and bottom. So if you check the table, I don't know if any of you have the textbook here. Right? If you don't, I can just quickly project it here. You can see for that one. There is the one. So if you have a cantilever beam, at least if you know, say if you have the V expression, the X expression. So the deflection is given by this here. 24 here, 6, 4, and then 1, right? Okay. So therefore, now let's come back to what do we have on this system. Okay. I'll say this is the same one, right? So this is okay. Now for a constant force, you can do the same. You have a control RB there, so you can find the solution will be this. And in the textbook, what you have actually is this one. They give you solution. So you have a cantilever beam. There is a load P here. They give you solution. farm was supposed to be the king. Now I put a negative army there. Why I put a negative army there? Because the, in the table, they show if you have a force going this way, they give you the deflection. Now I have a force this way, right? So the RB, I call it this way. I assume the RB is this way, therefore I have to put a negative RB. Because all the deflection is not pushing down, it's actually going over down. That's why I need a negative sign. So that's a very easy, but it is actually also very easy to get confused on this sign. Basically, what I'm saying is the sign, just be careful. Make sure it's a positive and negative deflection sign. So if the force is the same as shown in the table, use whatever they give you. If the force somehow, or the movement somehow, the other direction, then you use the negative sign. Okay, so now we have these two solutions, right? Now we just get from the table. Okay. So that, now what the solution, if you add them together, add them together, not add and subtract, right? At least I feel I can. Yeah. Alright, so that's the solution. Okay, now, the solution. However, okay, RB, we know RB. We do not. It's a load, but it's I know load. So how can we find the RB that is solution will be the same as we showed before. We need a compatibility, right? And compatibility, we say, is the boundary condition. And the boundary here is basically a point D. Okay, so how can you select the right RB? Make this one before this 2D add together. Select the RB, but make this beam here become the same as this one. How do you select the RB? Make the bottom beam that is more exactly the same as the top one. What kind of boundary condition you have to enforce there to make this happen? Yes. Have to make the B point move zero. Because if you don't apply the right RB, right, let's say you apply too much or too little, then this point B won't stay at zero. So either go move up a little bit or down a little bit. Then this beam will be not the same as the other beam. Therefore, you have to have a specific RB and make that point move by zero. That's the boundary condition, or the additional boundary condition, or the compatibility that we can use to define that solution. And you can use this boundary condition, or we call compatibility equation, to determine what's up. The idea is similar to the scheme. Okay, now, can we all do this? Take this equation, x equals L. Right? So let's just find one. So basically when x equals L, B must be zero. So zero on the left side. I'm just using this equation. What is x? X must be equal to L. Put x equals L into this equation. So on this side you have zero. Then on this side you have RB. X squared, so that's L squared. And then 6, right? So then 3L minus L. L. And then minus Q times L squared, and then 24. And then here will be 6L squared minus 4L squared minus plus L squared. That's right. Basically, just replace X with L. That gives you the deflection at X equals L. And that must be 0. Now from this, can we find our RB? Yes, everything else. How you use superposition to the action of the indeterminate. So I assume everyone can figure out the lobby. From here, you find Arby. Now, Arby, once you know Arby, you want to guess. Any questions or any comments? Okay, now, if you look at the table, so here's my next question. Is there any other alternative, make it even easier, even quicker, I can get the RB solution? Okay, if you look at the table here, right? They give you this Vx, but what do we use? Right? Okay, but also they give you other information here. They give you delta. Delta V is a minus of the QL solution. Right? Okay, now if you look at this solution, this one, they give you a solution of the Vx, V prime, and the delta V. That's the number three. Right? Okay, now everybody memorize this. Alright? Now let's go back to what we have here. Remember how we did the IV? We use this competitive bidding, this equation, right? So is there any way we can quickly just use this equation, find R? Okay. Set them equal here, which one equal to which? Why are they equal? And only one point. Point B only. Right? So you're right, only at one point. The other points are not. So at point B, they must be equal to each other, negative sign. Opposite direction. Or in other words, the direction, right, of this of the beam. Okay, the direction here, this part, plus the direction this part, and together should be zero. We know that's our competitive, that's our bounding condition. Now, can I quickly find out what's this one? What's this one? Yes, it's already given in the table, right? Okay, so it's already given in the table. What they give you? They give you, you have this beam here, right? Under a distributed load. They give you Q, the V at point B. So that's the delta at point B. Equal to, if you want to remember it, QL 4 over 8. Got it. Okay. Mouse from the table, you can find this stuff. Now look here. Okay, this is Q. This is B. Then the delta B will equal to what? Over 3 yards. Okay, remember. L to me, right? That's what you can find from the table. Now, can you use these two equations just quickly gather the RB? Yes, because I know this will equal to, in my case for me, negative RB, right? Because I have a negative RB here. So negative RB, then L cubic, and then 3 yards. So, what's my compatibility or the boundary condition? It's the delta V total, right? And that is delta V from the Q, delta V from the R. From the R, then plus the delta V from the Q. Must be zero, right? That's the correct equation. Yes, so that's the compatibility part, or the boundary condition. Okay, so therefore I can put this one in there. So immediately I get QL4, 8EI, and then plus negative R L cubic 3i, and that must be zero.
Now, cancel out RV?
Yes. Okay. Common terms, cancel out. Cubic, cancel out.
And get out. So, if you know where your boundary condition is, where your compatibility equation is, you can just use whichever equation that you let me give you that.
That's an alternative way of solving this same problem. But I feel this one may be a little bit quicker. Because you don't have to calculate further than x value there, x equals whatever value, and x is a long equation to calculate. They already give you this equation. Why don't you directly use it? That's how you save time, right? When you do an exam, there is under time, more pressure there. So quickly, it's the easiest way. That's how you save. Okay, any questions or comments? Yeah.
The question. Which is the long, very long one? Okay.
Well, it's the same here. I'm just copying this equation here. Yeah, so this is a total. The total will equal to that. Actually, yes, the logical was kind of computed, right? But yes, so I changed from A plus B, then B plus A. Yes. All right, any other questions? All right, if not, let's move on to cover more examples. Okay. Here is another approach, same example. Let's move on to another example. Okay, here is a
the top picture. You have a beam here. So, determinant or indeterminate? It's top picture. Indeterminate. Right? So, because we could have RA, RB, RC, three unknowns. You know, we only have two equations. Right? So, it's indeterminate. So, here, different reduced structure will play a big difference. Okay. There are ways, we know this is indeterminate, right? To solve it, we need reduced to a determinate structure. Right? Remove that redundant restriction and replace to a force. So there are two ways you can do it. One is you do like this. Okay, so you remove that restriction, so you're going to have an RB here, a force, a load. And you still have the load at the top. Right? You have this reduced structure. That's one way of solving. Another way, you can get this structure. So A here, still here, B is still here. So you have RA, RB, right? Still there. But you're this will be. So you have the low here. Okay. You remove the point C. So you have RC here. Now, this B and the two low, RC and this distribution low, Q. Determinant or indeterminate? Determinant. This is the top of our honeybee. Right? It's determined. It's too low. There's no movement here, right? But point C, just there is only a reaction force. So we change, remove that restriction, so therefore we have the reaction force. Okay, but once you remove it, now I have two points for A and B. Right? This is point A, this is point B. And this is our honey beam, but it's determined. Okay. Now for this determined beam, it's the reduced structure of this structure. Okay, now based on your judgment, just look at it. Which one is easy to solve? The one on the left or the one on the right? Because our honey will be hard to solve. Point 1B, there are the equation all M equation has to be changed. So therefore, our honey is never a good choice. Instead, we use this one. Because this is a simple beam, and we know simple beam. With the constant force of a distributed load, we all have to know the solution already. So in this case, okay, your judgment of select which one, and the redundant restriction, make a big difference. Okay, now let's say we select this one. How can we solve this one? We have to change this one into, divide into two problems. One is a single beam with a distributed load. Another is a single beam with a constant force. Now, for both of them, we know the solution. Yes, we know the solution, right? We want from the table. Okay, so now, what's the compatibility? Okay, what's the compatibility? How can you make this two problems, right, add together equal to this one? So what's the compatibility of the boundary condition? It is the deflection, right? And somewhere, must be very special value. What's the value? Consider. So when x equals to, actually, at point B, let's just say point B, equals 0. In other words, okay, so your V from the Q, that's generated at point B, then plus the V generated by this load R. R at point B and together must be zero. The distributed load pushes it down by 1 millimeter, then this reaction must push it back up by 1 millimeter back to zero. And that being what you put. Next. Okay, that's for that. So that's the compatibility, right? Now, how can we achieve this? We need to find out this. We generate by Q, and we generate by R. Now, how do we find that? You need particle, again, two ways. You can use the general V equation expression. Right? For this one, you have a Vx expression. You can, let's say x equals to the middle here. Let's call this part L, this part L. And the whole thing is 2L. And maybe you call the whole thing L, and each is half L. I think that's what giving the solution, right? So let's call the whole thing L, then this will be half L, half L. So and the middle one, right? Which one? Yeah, we're using deflection. This is the deflection. V is a deflection. Okay, now let's take a break from this spring. Look at this. Alright, look at the same OP. Okay, here. This is one solution. It's the appendix. Okay, it's on page 1086. Okay, so they give you the solution here. They give you the Vx, also they give you the delta V here, delta C. Where's delta C? Delta C is the middle. They directly give you the deflection at the middle. Therefore, we don't need to use this one. That's more calculation. Instead, we just use this, right? Okay, so let me write down here. Before it, that's 384, 5, right? So 5 QL4. Power 384 VI. You work out exactly the same. But if you use this equation, you have to put the x equals half L in there, and then calculate it. And when you calculate, you'll give you this. You don't need to calculate it. Put it. Now you calculate again. So just whatever the quickest one comes, right? So, and let's say, if I want the solution here, a point of the length, that they didn't give me, then I have to calculate. But they already gave me what the calculation is, then why I have to calculate. Whatever the easiest way, right? You want to be lazy in this sense. You don't want to do the actual one. Okay, so that's one. Now, look at the other solution. For me, the country report, they gave you this expression. Also, they give you the maximum of 46. That's 48, right? Okay, so let me write down. That's 48 EI and then PL cubic. Okay, so now let's go back to this screen. Okay, but I just copied there. Right? Assume I copied it correct. Right? Make sure you copy the equation correct. And that's definitely means that. Or copy the wrong equation. Okay, so now that's what I just copied from the book. Now in this situation, how can I use this equation? What should I put for P here? Negative RP. So I need to replace this one with a negative RP. And from here. So once I know RB, then I have everything else. If I do it, I can find the mean deflection equation, I can plot it. Or let's see if I want to know how much this point is going to move. Then you have final mean equation, not mean x. Alright, any questions here? Key point. One is reduced to the easiest structure, simple beam or cantilever. Second, just use the one give you direct solution to their deflection. Like this one, you know you need a deflection in the middle, so you just use this to give you in the middle deflection. The question
didn't say that. The question I can ask you, what's the reaction RB there? R A there, what's RC there? Or I can ask you at any point, what's the reaction there? That doesn't matter because this is not a problem. If you want, but anything you have to find the RB question. Okay, what's the deflection at the point C? RC? Zero. I know. That's an easy answer. Yeah, so now how can I find the R and RB? Put the dollars are RB value already known from here, right? Put it back to the equation of equilibrium. So I find the R and RB. I know R and RB. Combined. This is like the additional equation. That's why we call it compatibility. Okay, any other question? Alright, let's go over one more example. This one we can just read later on. So I want to go over another example. This one I will just leave there actually in the textbook. So you can all read it. I want to go to one more. This is an example that actually now combines what we learned from the D and what did we learn back in the axial load member bars, cable, together. Okay, so here is the situation. I have a cantilever beam, not this much, it's still low. Right? I'm just describing here. But for this one, I feel the cantilever beam not stable enough. Me too much. I want to make it more stronger. Make it stronger and stiffer, right? So therefore I put a cable at the bottom end. The length of the cable is H. Right? So the structure is now more, it's better, right? Stable. Okay. Now, for this structure, my question is, if I plant this load here, how much is this point going to move? What's the delta? Zero? Is it zero first? It won't. Because when you press on the beam, right? That load is going to form the cable edge there. If I have a rubber band, we just get it blocked. So therefore, we know it's not zero. Unless the, you know, the rubber band is huge. Now, this one is determinant or indeterminate? Determinant or indeterminate? Okay. No, it's indeterminate, by the way. It has three unknowns because the reaction here, if you cut off here, right? So that cable is going to be, if the beam before here, you can just drop the beam, actually, I have the beam. So for the beam, you're going to have a from the bar. So that's the and then this same force is going to pull this cable, making it elongated. So we know it's indeterminate. It's similar to your cantilever beam with a fixed support. Now, it is less. Under compression. The beam for the beam, of course, is lateral, so the beam just made it. Right? For the cable, it's the force pulling down. And we all have this occurrence, right? You're holding something, you're pulling it up. And then the load here is pushing it down, so you don't feel holding. So for the cable, it's the axial force, it's the elongation. But for the beam, now, how do we solve this problem? It's the same way, right? It's an indeterminate beam, so we use a way you can solve it. Of course, you can do the equations, or you can use superposition. Now, which way easier? I guess superposition, right? Okay, now let's use superposition. How do we find
moved here.
Then the beam is going down. The point is going down and turn up.
Okay. Right? Now, how much of the cable is on here?
So the beam. Right? It must move together. So the third of beam.
Third of beam of the beam must be equal to the third of elongation of the bar. That's the first step. The second step is, okay, now third of bar, can you calculate?
How
to
calculate the elongation of a bar?
Yes, that's in chapter 2, right? You have a bar there, and there is a force. And we know how to calculate. So this is the easy part. You know, it will be g times h over e of the b of the bar and a of the bar, right? That's it. Now, how do you become the deflection of the beam at point? What makes the beam at point B deflect? Two things. One is the distributed load, right? So the distributed load is going to make it move this much. Any location, right? And point D, actually we know. Remember that equation, delta B from the Q. Remember that equation? Q L 4 over 8 EI, right? Remember that? That's how much. Okay. So that's it. So the distributed load Q is going to make it. Now, what else makes this point move? Force. Pulling force from the key. And that is this key. Right? And how much does that make it move? So the delta point B from the tension, from the cable, how much is it? You want to remember that equation? Over 3 EI, right? 3 EI. And then the P, that's the P in this equation, P, L, Q. So,
this is the load. Pulling down. Of course, it's like pulling down. Okay?
So, therefore, what's the total movement of this P? It should be this two men together, right?
By adding together, I put the bottom side in Y. One tries to push it down, one to pull it down. Therefore, the difference,
this is the delta B.
It's managed. And that negative amount, negative effect, must equal to the, how much the bar.
So, therefore, let me see if I have space here. Okay, so therefore, what's our equation? Final equation. If you combine everything, what is all about here? You should have. Test of your memory again, right? So your delta B from the Q, and then delta B from the B, right? Must equal to the delta of the bar. Okay. So this one we know is A EI Q L4, right? This one we know must be E L3. 3 EI, right? This one goes up, so this one goes down, this one goes up. So I call it this.
Right? Down, I call it down, how do you? Then this is the next one.
Okay. And then this equal to third amount. What's the third amount? P, H, E, A. Now, is this E the same as the other E?
Maybe, maybe not. In a bar, the cable is the same as the beam or not.
In general, they may be not. So maybe you want to put a B there. And this A is from the bar, and the H is the bar.
Yeah, L is the beam, and the H is the bar. In general, they may be different. That's why I use the H instead of the beam.
Okay, so that's the equation. And that's result of this compatibility equation. Or in other words, delta B equals to delta bar. That's the compatibility. here, and then you plug everything in, you can fix out this equation. Now, if you solve this equation, find out the tension. Once you have a tension key, you get everything else. Right? Once you have a tension key, immediately from here, you can get this third box. And that's the answer to the question. And the question asks how much points. Right? So try to finish this process yourself. Any questions? Yeah, soon you know ER. Oh, not only can be I know, but all everything else. I tell you how much that point is before. You figure out what the beam should I do. That's a design problem. It's ridiculous. Okay, thank you. Talk about